department of the Lord is mighty. The Lord is mighty. Mighty are the works of his hands. He's an awesome God. He's a big God. We serve a mighty God. And we give him glory today. Amen. So we just ask that you, that if you can, get up on your feet and give God some glory with us. Amen. As we worship him in spirit and in truth. And if you can't stand, clap your hands. If you can't clap your hands, wave your hands. If you can't wave your hands, shake your head. If you can't shake your head, stomp your foot. Amen. Do something to give him some glory. Amen. Ooh. Say, Lord, you're mighty.
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 Say, Lord, you're mighty.
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 Oh, Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. Well, you set your glory above the heavens and the earth. The sun, the moon, and the stars. Well, that's no praise is high enough to express how great you are. What a mighty God.
What a mighty God.
We serve a mighty God. being mighty.
Yes, God.
Thank you, God.
We give
Nobody
you glory,
can compare
God.
To you.
We give you honor, oh God. Hallelujah. Yes, God. We just praise you, oh God.
Thank you, Lord. And because you are so mighty, God, we got to praise you. We got to give you glory. We got to honor you, God. You're so worthy. You're so worthy. From the rising of the sun to the setting down of the same, you are worthy. Your name is worthy to be praised, God. And we're going to praise you forever and ever. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Glory to your name, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. He's worthy to. Come on and give him the glory. Come on and give him the glory. There's no other name that can be saved by but the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus. Everything you need.
Let me talk about the one who taught me how to love. I saw him on the water, he was bidding me to come. With every step I hesitate, and my faith went away. You're everything I need, I'm never letting go. You're right next to me, so take the lead, oh Lord. I follow you through the darkness. Will you take away my fear? Follow you when the sun shines and the shadows drawing near. Down the long and winding road, you always lead me home. If the water looks too deep and the desert looks too dry, he said, tell me why you're walking when I taught you how to fly. With every step I take, I feel the weight go away. I couldn't even see when I didn't think of you. You thought of me, so take the lead. Oh Lord,
Thank you for making us whole, oh God. Because, God, we were broken and we didn't know which way to turn. But, God, you saw fit to love us in spite of us. And for that, God, I just want to tell you, thank you, Lord. And, God, we ask you to word my mouth, give me what to say and how to say it. But pray your people's heart to receive us. Thus say the Lord. God, we ask you to crucify me, oh God. It's not about me, but it's all about you. God, help me to say something that's going to encourage your people to continue to live for you. Let me say something that's going to turn hearts towards you, oh God. Because, God, this is an evil and sinful world that we're living in. And, God, we cannot make it without you. But, God, we know with you all things are possible. So, God, we ask you to do all of these things in your Son Jesus' name. Thank God. Amen and amen. While you're yes saying, if you would, get your Bibles or your phones or whatever means you have the Word of God, turn to 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter. 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter. And if you don't have anything, if you don't feel like turning, amen, it's on the screen. Amen. It's on the screen. Thank God for technology. Amen. And it reads this thus. For I have received from the Lord the teaching that I pass on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took a piece of bread, gave thanks to God, broke it, and said, this is my body, which is for you. Do this in memory of me. And in the same way, after the supper, he took the cup and said, this cup is God's new covenant, sealed with my blood. Whenever you drink it, do so in memory of me. This means that every time you eat this bread and drink from this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Oh, Heavenly Father, we ask you to bless this word. Let it fall on the good ground. In due time, let it bring forth a harvest. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I just thank God for allowing us together, amen, for the last month of this year of 2023. Amen. And I look back and I can see how I've had different challenges, but I thank God through them all, I'm yet here. And I know it's only because of God's grace and mercy that we are all yet here, but we just want to thank God for it. You know, some people have had difficult days, amen, in 2023, because if I look back over the year, amen, I can see some that are not here that started off the year. But amen, but we thank God that we are yet here. Amen. Now, I don't know about you all, but I realize that we're living in the last days. I know they've been saying that for a long time, but if you really look at what's really going on around us, we are really living in the last days. Amen. Whenever they're calling wrong right, and they're calling right wrong, amen, there's something wrong with that picture. Amen. Nowadays, they want the people that's living for the devil to have more rights than the people that's living for God. And it's a sad thing when people are calling wrong right. And, but one thing about it, God is a holy God. One thing about our God that we serve, he's a holy God. And he says since he's holy, he declares he wants us to be holy. Amen. Amen. Now, We thank God for the Bible. Amen. Amen. Because, see, this is our basic instructions before leaving earth. Amen. So we should, amen, study this word, eat this word, dissect this word. We should live by this word. Amen. If anything you need in this life, anytime you need directions for anything in this life, amen, you can pick up that Bible, amen, and ask God what it is he'll have for you to do. Amen. Amen. Here we see in this passage of scripture we just read. Amen. Matter of fact, my subject today is follow Jesus' example. Amen. Follow Jesus' example. That's my topic for the day. I'll be talking to you briefly. Here, this is exactly what Paul is instructing the people to do. Amen. Paul is telling the people to follow the example that Jesus had left behind. Amen. We know that Jesus, he was God in the flesh. Amen. And that, there are so many things that he did while he was here on this earth. Amen. As followers of God, we need to follow Jesus' example. Amen. You might say, well, Jesus was God in the flesh. How can I follow the things that he did? But my Bible lets me know Jesus said, greater works shall ye do than what he did. So that lets us know that we are able to do greater works. Amen. Because, see, Jesus was just a limited where he could travel. Amen. But I could be in Louisiana this morning. By tomorrow morning, I could be in China. Amen. Spreading this gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen. That's why we can do greater works. Amen. Because we can carry this gospel, amen, beyond, amen, just this particular region, beyond this particular area. Amen. We can spread this gospel all over the world. Amen. But you know, my Lord, he did so many wonderful things while he was here on this earth. Amen. I just wouldn't know where to begin to tell you, amen, some of the things we should be able to do. But one of the things you hear a whole lot of people talking about, amen, they don't see anymore. They don't see, amen, demons being cast out. They say they don't see the lame getting up and walk. They say that they don't see the deaf, amen, begin to hear. They don't see the dumb begin to speak. But my question to you is, what are you doing? Amen. It's not all about what the pastor's doing or what the missionary is doing. Amen. What are you doing as a follower of Jesus Christ? Amen. It's up to each and every one of us to be a representative of our Lord. Amen. It's not up just to the pastor. It's not up just to the person that may have a title. Amen. Each and every one of us have an assignment. Each and every one of us have a responsibility. Amen. While we are yet living here on this earth. Amen. You know, it's a sad thing when you have people that's, when you talk to people and they'll say they don't want anything else to do with God. And baffle me. I wonder why are you saying you don't want to have anything else to do with God? Amen. And then I finally had an individual to explain to me why they didn't want to have anything else to do with God. They let me know that because of the life that they saw a lot of the people living to say that they were saved, amen, they were some of the biggest hypocrites in the world. And all I can say was, help us, Lord. Amen. But you know, it's a sad thing when a person comes to church and say, I thank God that I'm saved and I'm sanctified, I'm baptized and filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost, with the evidence of speaking in the tongues as the Spirit give utterance. Amen. And as soon as they leave the church, they go home to their sugar daddy or they go home to their sugar mama. You know, it's a sad thing. Amen. We're setting that type of example when people are watching you, because sometimes you'll be the only Bible that a person may ever read. I know y'all might not get no amen today, but I'm just going to tell it like a T-I-S is. Amen. You know, it's a sad thing. Amen. As you belong to God, it doesn't matter what you may be caught up in. Amen. My Bible lets me know when a woman was caught in the act of adultery. Amen. She was caught in the very act of adultery, and they brought her before Jesus and wanted to know what Jesus had to say about it. Amen. Jesus was lying on the ground, and he began to write something in the ground. And I can imagine in my mind, he might have looked up and saw John. He might have wrote John. I can imagine in my mind, he might have saw David. He might have wrote down David. Then I can imagine in my mind, he could have saw somebody named Joe. He could have wrote Joe. But then he said, you without sin, cast the first stone. Then I can imagine they could do nothing but walk away sad. Amen. None of us are perfect. We're striving for perfection. Amen. It's going to all of us, amen, praying and seeking God to be able to make it in. I don't know about y'all, but I thank God, amen. I feel a little help right now. Amen. Because I know my God, he's able to do anything but fail. Yeah, I don't know about y'all, but my God, I don't care what may be going on in your life right now. Amen. You may be facing a storm or different challenges in your life, but I know a man can speak to the storm, and the storm has to be still. I don't know about y'all. Amen. But I can imagine many things that my Lord, he's done. Amen. He set an example for us. Amen. You may have a storm. You may receive some bad news from a doctor. Amen. But I'm here to tell you today, but I know a man that has never lost a patient. You may be serving. I mean, you might have got served some a notice in the mail. You may have had the sheriff come knock on your door and give you a subpoena. But I know a man that he's a lawyer, has never lost a case. I don't know about you, but I'm here to tell you today, all you got to do is depend on God. I don't know about y'all, but see, we just celebrated Thanksgiving. And we tried to make sure in Harvest Temple everybody has something to eat. Amen. Because, see, my Bible, he's concerned about everybody. He want to make sure everybody has a complete meal. Well, Pastor, how do you know? Because, see, my Bible tells me that there was a time when he was teaching the people. Amen. Then Jesus said, send the people away. Amen. But then the disciples said, well, they don't have anything to eat. Amen. But then Jesus looked and said, what do you have among you? And they looked out in the audience. There was a little lad that only had two little fish and five loaves of bread. Amen. But then my Bible lets me know that Jesus told them to sit down. When you sit down at the master's feet, don't you know he's going to take care of all of your needs? My Bible said he got the two little fish and five loaves of bread. He looked up toward heaven and he blessed the bread. And he blessed the fish. Then the Bible said he began to distribute to the people. Amen. He fed 5,000 men, and not including the women and the children. So my God, he's concerned that all of us have enough to eat. Amen. Not only physical food, but don't you know you have to be able to eat the spiritual food. I don't know about y'all, but see, a lot of people, they want to take what's fitting to them. Amen. But my Bible lets me know we have to eat the whole roll. Even when it tastes good, you got to eat it. Amen. When it may not taste too good, you still got to eat it. Amen. When it tell you to stop doing what you're doing and it feels good to you, you just got to stop doing what you're doing. Because don't you know it's a terrible thing to fall into the hands of an angry God. Amen. My God, he sit high and he looks low. Amen. Everything you do, he has his angel recording it. Amen. But everything you do that you don't repent of, you're going to have to stand before God and give an account. But don't you know, my Bible lets me know if you make a mistake, amen, don't you know when you ask God to forgive you, amen, everything they're recording with a pencil. But every time you ask God to forgive you, they have to turn the pencil around and get the eraser. They have to erase what you've done, amen, against the will of God. Well, Pastor, how do you know? Because I hear David saying, well, let me testify. Amen. David was a man after God's own heart. But David had a few flaws in his life. Amen. Because you remember the time David was looking out and he saw a woman named Bathsheba bathing. Amen. Then David lusted after her. Amen. Then not only did he lust after her, David had a relationship with her. Amen. But then you know David and her, they conceived a son. Amen. But as time went by, the son died. But then David, he asked God to please, but when God sent the prophet Nathan to tell David that he had sinned against God. Amen. Then David fell down and he said, God, please forgive me because I've sinned against thee. Against thee only have I sinned. So my Bible lets me know that if you want to be a person that pleases unto God, you have to be able to repent and ask God to please forgive me. No matter what you may have done, no matter what the devil may try to make you think you can't be forgiven for, my Bible lets me know you need to repent quickly. Amen. I don't know about you, but I know that any time I make a mistake, I know I'm not perfect, but I know how to fall on my knees and ask God to forgive me. Amen. I don't know about you, but every now and then we got to crucify the flesh. We can't live trying to please the flesh and trying to please God. How can two walk together except they agree? I don't know about you, but they say two birds of a feather, they'll flock together. So you have to be careful with the company you keep. You can't run around with everybody. Sometimes you got to draw the line in the sand and say, I'm not going to partake in that anymore. Because God, he has delivered me. He has set me free. I'm not bound anymore because his stripes has healed me. I don't know about y'all, but every now and then, I see some people that hang around the corner where I used to hang. And they say, Joe, why you don't come around anymore? Because God, he has set me free. When the Son sets free, he is free indeed. I don't know about y'all, but I thank God for freedom on today. I don't want to go back to bondage. I don't want to go back to being bound by the devil. You know what you got to do is whenever the devil tempts, you got to fall on your knees. You got to push that plate back. You got to push the plate back and say, I'm fast, I'm going to pray. Because this thing, I can't deliver myself on my own. Because I'm weak, but I know that he's strong. So we got to learn to depend on God. Amen. Here we see in our passage of scripture today, Paul, amen, he told the people, he said, have received of the Lord the teaching that passed on to me, to you, that the Lord on the night that he was betrayed. I don't know about y'all, but see, Paul, he received a revelation from God. Anytime you receive something from God, you need to eat the whole road. Paul said that sometimes there are betrayals, there's sometimes even betrayals in the church. I don't know about y'all, but sometimes it's a hurtful thing when you think a person is saved and you find out they've been talking about you behind your back. Amen. They've been doing everything, according to everything, but a child of God. So what we got to do is learn how to lean and depend on God. We got to look to God and not to man, because man will let you down. See, Paul let us know that everybody in the church is not what they're proclaiming to be. Amen. Everybody in your circle, they're not what they're saying they are. So what you got to do, you got to keep your eye on God, because people will let you down. People will disappoint you. Amen. Don't keep your eye on me. Keep your eye on God, because I know God is all right. How many know he's all right? Ain't God all right? If you know he's all right, come on and say, yeah. Ain't God all right? Come on and say, yeah, I know he's all right. Come on and thank God today. See, Paul, he let us know what Jesus instructed the disciple to do. Amen. Jesus told the disciple, do this in remembrance of me. I don't know about y'all, but I want to do everything God commanded me to do. Amen. So what we got to do, we got to do everything God called us to do. Amen. See, anytime you get ready to take communion, we got to look back. Amen. See, you got to look back, see where God has brought you from. I know he brought me from a mighty long way. Did he bring anybody else from a mighty long way? So we got to look back and tell the Lord, thank you for where you brought me from. Thank you for where I am right now. Thank you for where you're going to take me. Amen. Not only do we have to look back, we got to look inward. The Bible said, let a man examine himself to see if he's worthy to partake of the Lord's supper. Amen. If you find out that something that's not right within you, you got to ask the Lord, please forgive me. Because I don't want to drink damnation onto my soul. So you got to look inward at yourself. Amen. Don't worry about your brother. Don't worry about your sister. You got to look within your own self. And if anything in there that should not be, you got to ask God to please take it away from me. Then not only do you have to look backward, you don't have to only look inward. You got to look outward. So whenever the Lord saves you, you got to go out and try to save the lost. You got to go out and encourage the sinner that there's a better life. Amen. There is a better way. You got to encourage that drunkard. You don't have to drink that bottle. Amen. You got to encourage that smoker. Amen. You can put that smoke down. Amen. You got to encourage the one that's shooting up. You can put the needle down. You can encourage the one that's looking at pornography. Amen. You got a wife at home. Go home and be with your wife. You got to encourage those that are out of the will of God. Not only do you have to look backward. Not only do you have to look inward. Not only do you have to look outward. But I'm here to tell you today, now we got to look upward. Because Jesus, he said in his word, when he left his disciples, he said, you see me go, and I shall come again. So we got to be ready when he returns. Don't you know he's coming back for a prepared church? It's not time to try to get ready. Because when he comes, you got to be ready. We got to be ready when he parts the clouds. We got to be ready to meet him in the air. Because my Bible says that those that are dead, they shall be rise first. Amen. They shall be raised first. But those who yet remain shall be caught up in the air to meet them in the sky. I want to be ready when he comes. I don't want anything holding me down. Everything may not be a sin, but some things can be a weight. Don't you know when you're weighted down, when you try to go up, you can't get up off the ground, because you'd be weighted down. Amen. But I want to tell you today, you got to lay aside every sin. You got to lay aside every weight when you want to meet him in the air. Because when you lay it down, when he comes, we'll be able to go up and be with our Lord. How many want to see him in peace? How many want to see him? God, I know he's all right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't know about y'all, but I know he, every day goes by is one day closer to his return. Every day that goes by is one day closer. Mess everybody the same. Everybody said it. Everybody close your eyes. Everybody close your eyes. I don't want nobody peeping. Now, if there's anybody in the audience today, everybody's eyes is closed. I don't want to see nobody looking at me. Everybody's eyes closed. Now, you know if there's something in your heart, that if the Lord was to come back right now, that you wouldn't be able to see his face in peace. Something that you've been struggling with, and it seemed like you just cannot get rid of it. I'm not trying to embarrass anybody. I just want to pray with you. I'm not going to ask anybody to come up. I just want you to raise your hands where you are. Thank you. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Put your hands down. Put them down. God don't want nobody to peep. Now, if there's one today that you've been praying for your loved one, you know that they are doing some things that they should not be doing. And you don't want them to be lost. Raise your hand right quick. Meditate on God. Don't think about who's on the right, who's on the left. Don't worry about who's in front of you. Just meditate on God. But I'm here to tell you today, God, he's delivered. God, he's able to set you free. Told me to tell you, he's there. He's right here. He's right here to make you strong where you're weak. But what you have to do, you have to make up in your mind, say enough is enough. You got to make up in your mind, say enough is enough. And I'm not going to yield to that anymore. And God, he will strengthen you where you're weak.
Lord, we surrender.
Oh, Heavenly Father.
Yes, we surrender.
We actually look at these are your people, oh God.
Surrender.
These are the people that's called by your most holy name.
Surrender.
God, they're admitting today that they have a weakness in their life and they need your strength because they can't do it on their own. They tried and they failed. They tried and they failed. They tried and they come up short. So God, we ask you to come in and take full control of that situation even right now, oh God. Because God, we can't do it on our own. We can't do it. We tried, God, but we can't do it. We're admitting that we can't do it. So God, please forgive us. Forgive us even right now. I'm sorry. I'm sorry for disappointing you, God. I'm sorry for coming up short. I'm sorry for yielding to the temptation. I'm sorry for disappointing you, but God, please forgive me even now. I ask you to wipe my slate clean and bless me to start all over again. And God, if you do these things, I'm going to forever praise you. I'm going to forever worship you. I'm going to forever lift your most holy name up. Because God, there's none other name above your name. And God, we actually look on our loved ones today, oh God. Our loved ones that's not doing everything that they should be doing. Our loved ones that's falling short. We ask you to have mercy upon them even right now. Move on to their heart. Move in their mind. Move in their heart even right now. Turn their heart and their mind towards you. Because if you were to return, they will be forever separated from you. We don't want to see anybody go to hell. Use us. We'll win it best us to be used by you, to be a light to them, to encourage them to live a life that's pleasing unto you. So whenever we're in that midst, we ask you to give us what to say and how to say it, and prepare their hearts to receive what's said. If you do these things, we're going to forever praise you. We're going to forever worship you. We ask you to do all these things in your Son Jesus' name we pray. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Amen. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise as you take your seat. Come on, no. I say give the Lord a hand clap of praise as you take your seat.
Everything I give to you.
We're going to get ready to prepare to partake of the Lord's Holy Communion.